Hi again, everybody. I am Dr. Sam Zoranovich, and in this section, we're going to be talking about some movement practices that help control the feelings of anxiety and the neurological state of fight or flight activation that can lead to it. So far, we've covered brushing and stroking and squeezing, ways of touching your body that can help calm the brain down. Now we're going to do some movement practices. So if for whatever reason you can't touch your body or it's not working to do that, you can try this. So the first thing I want to introduce you to is the idea of seaweed. So for a seaweed movement practice, the important thing to remember is we're just doing an impersonation of a stalk of seaweed at the bottom of the ocean in a very slow, gentle current. You can't see my knees and ankles right now, but they are soft, not rigid, not held. I'm trying to make sure that every joint in my foot, my knee, my hip, gets a chance to move a little bit. And then I'm gonna make sinuous movement come up the spine really gently and try to avoid eliciting a stretch response. People are often tempted to stretch. We're not trying to stretch, we're just flowing inside the easy range of motion. If you have a lot of injuries in your past, or if you are just generally very stiff as a body, then your seaweed might be this small or even smaller. I'm pretty flexible just by nature, and so my seaweed is about yay big. What we're trying to do with this practice is, as I said, stay inside the lines. We're coloring inside the lines of where any stretch response might happen. And just having this gentle, sinuous, wavy movement through the spine starts to flood the brain with movement information from every joint. Now, let's say I had an ache, a pain, or something not quite right here in the shoulder. Then you can imagine that doing this might be kind of intense and hurt and provocative, which is exactly not the thing. So if something hurts somewhere, go even more gently, even more slowly, and even more softly. Again, you're not cheating by making the seaweed very tiny. That's in fact part of the point. Usually, I advise my patients to do about 20 seconds of standing seaweed practice throughout the day, especially if they notice themselves ramping up towards that fight or flight response, that aggravated intensity. How much I've done is plenty. And I'll do that once, maybe twice in a day. And when I do that, I notice a sense of deeper breathing, softening, release, relaxation, and ideally, my brain just slows down a little bit to match the movement speed. And that's the point here. You can absolutely practice seaweed well seated, and you can practice seaweed from just the neck up. So here I'm going to show you just a little bit of just neck seaweed. And even as I'm doing it now, I can feel a calming sensation spread through the tissue. My breath drops and slows down. And it just sort of feels good. All of these practices, from the brushing and stroking, to the squeezing, to the slow sinuous movement, all of them should feel somewhere between totally neutral and really good. If they feel anything like stress, strain, push through, I guess I can put up with this because it's good for me, you've missed it. So slow it down, shrink it, make it more gentle.